And welcome to my YouTube channel. On our today's channel, I'm going to show you how we are going to find the zero for any polynomial equations. That means I'm going to show you a particular example how we find the zero or how we are going to find the solution of the reality. A particular example of a polynomial function or equation that's really important to determine the zeros of some other polynomial functions based on this particular example. And hence, a polynomial function is generally considered as a special kind of algebraic functions, because there are many kinds of functions, and these functions are generally classified as either a transcendental functions or an algebraic function. So this polynomial is one of a very important, or this is the fundamental or the basic kind of an algebraic function. So now let's see how we are going to find the zero for or the reals of a particular example of the polynomial equations, and because of this method of finding this equation, you can find the zero of any polynomial problem generally. So now let's see this particular example. Now solve this problem. Solve the given equation minus x cubed plus 3x squared minus 4, which is equal to 0. This is a particular example of polynomial equations. So how we are going to determine the solution of this particular polynomial equations? So therefore, in order to determine the zero for this problem or the real roots of this equation, now first of all, let us use a very important method, which is a possible rational root test theorem. So based on the rational root test theorem, let's find first of all possible rational zeros of these equations. So now let's see. Now this implies that, let's assume that let P be a factor of minus 4, which is a constant term. And similarly, this implies that, first of all, this implies that P will be plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, and plus or minus 4 will be the function of the constant this one. And with similar technique, let's assume that Q be another factor, a factor of a coefficient of the leading term, factor of the coefficient of the leading term. So minus 1 is the coefficient of the leading term, as you see. Now, on this polynomial equation, you know what leading term in general means, which is the highest, which is the term that has the highest exponent in the polynomial equations. So this implies that k is written as plus or minus 1. Now, let me show how the possible rational zero of this equation can be taken out. So this implies that p over q, which is equal to plus or minus 1 divided by this, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2 divided by plus or minus 1, that is plus or minus 2, plus or minus 4 divided by plus or minus 1 will be plus or minus 4. And which is called, this is called possible, now we call this is the possible rational zero of the equation. Now this is the possible rational zero of this equation. Therefore, from this possible, we have 8 different possible rational zero for this equation. So which number is generally considered as the real zeros of this equation? Therefore, in order to detect or in order to find out or select from the given this number, that is the zero of this, let us use a synthetic division method. That's a very simple and interesting method of finding the zero of any polynomial equations in general. So now let's see. Therefore, now in order to find zeros of this problem, let's use the synthetic division method. Now we have let's consider minus 1. Let's consider the first 1 or minus 1. We can take 1. And let's consider the coefficient of this term in general. Minus 1, 3, 0 and minus 4. You know that 0 is the coefficient of x. There is no x here, because when we describe these in the standard form of the polynomial functions, now this is written as minus x cubed plus 3x squared plus 0x minus 4, which is equal to 0. Based on a polynomial function, now this can be described in the form of this one. They're absolutely same or equivalent. So now let's just drop these as it is. That is minus 1. 1 times minus 1 is exactly minus 1. 3 plus minus 1 will be, that is 2. 1 times 2 will be 2. 0 plus is 2. 1 times 2 is 2. Minus 4 plus 2 is minus 2. Which is absolutely different from, this is absolutely different from 0. So because of this, now, since the last result, that is minus 2 is different from 0, this implies that 1 could not be the 0 of this one. It's not considered as 0 of the equation. This couldn't make these algebraic expression 0. So this is not the 0 of this one. And let's just consider the second point. That is minus 1. Similarly, let's just take this one, minus 1, say 0 and minus 4. And let's drop this as it is. That is minus 1. Minus 1 times minus 1 is 1. This 3 plus 1 is 4. Minus 1 times 4 is minus 4. And 0 plus minus 4 is minus 4. And minus 1 times minus 4 will be 4. Minus 4 plus 4 will be 0. It's exactly 0, you see? Now finally, this shows that, this implies that minus 1 is 0 of, this is 0 of the equation. So this will be the 0 of the given equation. Now we call minus 1 is 0 of the given equation. So this implies that, since minus 1 is the 0 of the equation, so this implies x plus 1 is a factor of the given factor of the algebraic expression, the equation, the given minus x cubed plus 3x squared plus minus 4. This will be the factor of this one. And let's take a second number from the possible rational zero. Now, let's just assume that x plus 1 is one factor of the given this polynomial expression. So let's just consider 2. Minus 1, 3, 0, and minus 4. Let's just drop these as minus 1. 2 times minus 1 is exactly minus 2. 3 plus minus 2 is 1. 2 times 2 is this one, 2. 0 plus 2 is 2. 2 times 2 is, that is 4. And minus 4 plus 4 will be 0. So this, with similar technique of this one, so this implies that 2 is 0 of the given equation. 0 of the equation. Now 2 is a 0. 2 is a 0 of this equation. This 2 will make this expression 0. So this implies that x minus 2 is a factor of the given equation. X factor. Simply, this is the factor of this formula. So now let's just check. No need of checking the other factor for these algebraic or polynomial expression in general. And now this implies therefore generally minus x cubed plus 3x squared minus 4 is written as x minus 2 times x plus 1 times another variable or another factor a. Because since it is a degree 3 polynomial, so the product of these two terms is degree 2 polynomial. So if you multiply a degree 2 polynomial by another term which is a, now that will be degree 3. So let's find a. Now this implies that when we solve a is equivalently given by minus x cubed plus 3x squared minus 4 divided by x minus 2 into x plus 1, which is exactly x minus 2. That means, based on a polynomial division algorithm, if you divide this polynomial for this polynomial, the result will be this one. So this implies that minus x cubed plus 3x squared minus 4 is written as x minus 2 the whole square into x plus 1, which is 0. So now finally, this implies that from this, you can take this implies that x is equal to 2 or x is equal to minus 1 are zeros of the equation. Now x is equal to 2 and x is equal to minus 1 will be the zero of the given equation, this one. So based on this method, based on a synthetic division method, now we call this is generally a synthetic division method. Based on this method, you can find the zero of any polynomial equation in general. You can find the rational zeros of the polynomial based on this synthetic division method. Therefore, this is all about our today's lesson. If you have any question, any doubts or any comment regarding to this one, you are welcome. If not, thank you for today. And if you are a new member of my channel, don't forget to subscribe my channel. And thank you very much for watching my YouTube channel. Thank you, bye-bye.